Eunice Wayman, who would later take on the stage name Nina Simone, was born in the small town Tryon, North Carolina, on February 21, 1933. Her mother, Mary Wayman, was a Methodist preacher, and her father, John Wayman, was a reverend, so she adopted the genre of gospel music from a very young age. It was at the Methodist church that she began to play the piano for crowds, which led her to start playing at outside functions. After graduating high school at the top of her class, her small town community raised money for a scholarship used to send Eunice to New York City's famed Juilliard School of Music. At Juilliard, she trained in classical music with the hopes of getting into the Curtis Institute of Music. However, she was denied entry to the school because of her race, which fueled her already existing passion for civil rights activism. In 1954, she made her first public appearance as a singer under the name Nina Simone at the Midtown Bar in Atlantic City. She took on the name partly in honor of her favorite actress and partly to hide her nightclub singing from her mother, whose religious sensibilities forbade it. Nina Simone is primarily known as a singer, despite never having received formal vocal training. Her powerful and deep tone is among the most distinctive of her era, with hints of androgyny adding to her enchanting allure. Simone also made sure that the public was aware of her training as a classical pianist by integrating Bach style and romantic composition in her playing, helping to create her unique fusion of classical, jazz, blues, gospel, soul, and folk. Her Midtown performances quickly brought her to the attention of jazz fans, writers, and record executives. She was offered her first recording contract with Bethlehem Records in 1959. From there, Simone's career took off. She went on to receive 15 Grammy nominations for some of her most acclaimed songs, and my personal favorites, Ain't Got No, I Got Life, and I Put a Spell on You. In 2000, Simone won the Grammy Hall of Fame Award and became a Billboard Top 20 hit for her rendition of I Loves You Porgy. She also received an honorary degree from the Curtis Institute, the school that had denied her acceptance on the basis of discrimination when she was first starting off as a professional singer and pianist. Simone's involvement with the civil rights movement began with an incident at her first classical recital at the age of 12, when her parents were moved from their seats to make space for white people. In response to this, she refused to perform until her parents were returned to their original seats. This proved to be the first of many incidents when Simone would use her position to publicly condemn injustice against black people. By the mid-1960s, Simone became known as a key voice in the civil rights movement. She wrote a song called Mississippi Goddamn in response to the 1963 assassination of Medgar Evers and the Birmingham church bombing that killed four young African-American girls. She protested especially against the Jim Crow laws, writing a song called Old Jim Crow during the same time these laws were finally being overruled. In her final years, reports indicated that Nina Simone was battling breast cancer. She died at the age of 70 on April 21st, 2003, at her home in the south of France. Simone sang to share her truth, which left a lasting impression on the world of music and activism. Her legacy lives on through her recordings and the countless artists who were influenced by her genius.